Baltimore, today marks my one-year anniversary in office. Together, we have made great strides over the past year and positioned our city for the continued work ahead. We battled COVID-19 together, with over 360,000 residents having had at least one dose of the vaccine, and we've maintained one of the lowest positivity rates in the state throughout the pandemic. As a result of this steadfast leadership and commitment to science, Baltimore has received national recognition for our approach in handling COVID-19. We steadied the ship by restoring key services like recycling, as well as essential in-person services for our residents. This work continues as we install the technology necessary to allow for hybrid meetings as we prepare to safely reopen the doors of City Hall to the public. And while I've effectively used this past year to lay the groundwork for a better future, I also took immediate action to aid Baltimoreans across the city. Reducing gun violence, Baltimore's longest standing public health crisis, remains my top priority. That's why I released Baltimore's first ever comprehensive violence prevention plan in July, outlining the immediate steps and targeted strategies my administration is undertaking to stem the tide of violence. This year, our focus was on building the foundation, and we are preparing to take this work to the next level in 2022, accelerated by a $50 million investment that will help the Mayor's Office of Neighborhood Safety and Engagement implement our group violence reduction strategy, where we intensely focus on those most likely to be the victim of gun violence through not only law enforcement, but also employment programs, housing, and other services. This investment will also increase the number of community violence intervention programs from 10 to 30, strengthen resources for residents returning home from prison, and better support residents and communities after a shooting has occurred. This year, we partnered with Everytown for Gun Safety on a first-of-its-kind portal to allow Baltimore to better hold gun traffickers and straw purchasers accountable for their role in violence. And in an effort to end the finger-pointing and focus on the work of collaboratively saving lives, my administration stepped up to the plate to reestablish the Criminal Justice Coordinating Council after it was defunded at the state level, immediately strengthening coordination and communication across federal, state, and local public safety agencies in the fight against violent crime. We established a citywide 911 call diversion pilot program to divert appropriate behavioral health calls to trained professionals, allowing police to focus their attention on violence. This pilot has shown great success, and we're preparing to expand the 911 call diversion program to additional calls for service in the new year. We also secured enabling legislation to bring the Baltimore Police Department from state control to local control, work that's underway as we work to get this matter on the ballot in 2022. And as we work to build a safer city, we also remain focused on building an equitable city. We kicked off a ranging process to reform Baltimore's outdated procurement system through a lens of equity. Baltimore cannot be the best version of itself until it does business in a 21st century way, recognizing the value of local, small, minority, and women-owned businesses. This fall, we released our five-year strategic economic development plan called Baltimore Together, a platform for inclusive prosperity. And we are now investing millions of dollars to support small business growth and recovery with a focus on our small Black and brown businesses. Investing $30 million, we made an unprecedented investment into the economic potential of our residents, including our young people. This investment includes Train Up, which offers occupational skills training, and the establishment of a year-round YouthWorks program. This is just one of many efforts my administration has taken to prioritize our young people, who are the future of our great city. This year, we opened new rec centers like the Cahill Fitness and Wellness Center and reopened centers like Tawanda and Bocek that had been closed for years, bringing the total of our rec centers open to 52, up from 40 just a few years ago. And my administration is planning an even deeper investment in rec and parks, which we look forward to sharing with you in the very near future. We are stepping up our efforts to reach out to our disconnected youth to ensure that they have wraparound services and support that they need to realize their true potential. Additionally, our work to build a guaranteed income pilot program for Baltimore is well underway, targeted at increasing economic security among our low-income residents. That program will launch very early in the new year. I announced our city's short and long-term strategy for reforming the tax sale process with a focus on providing relief to homeowners facing liens on their properties, in particular, our legacy residents and older adults at risk of losing their homes. We are also laying the groundwork to not just bridge the digital divide, but close it for good with our first investment of $35 million announced last week, which will bring increased public Wi-Fi access to 10 West Baltimore neighborhoods. These investments are making sure that we not only emerge from the pandemic, but that we emerge stronger. We are opening mixed-use and affordable housing, revitalizing neighborhoods throughout all of Baltimore. And as we consider strengthening our downtown corridor and our incredible neighborhoods, our vision is focused on inclusive and sustainable economic growth. This year, we made more funding available to community land trusts, which create long-term affordable housing opportunities, as well as to our older adults seeking to age in place with dignity. My administration has also been focused on building clean and healthy communities. This year, we restarted bulk trash pickup and got back out into our neighborhoods for our regular cleanups. And right now, we're distributing recycling carts to our residents. This is about building a city long-term Baltimoreans can enjoy and thrive in by building an effective and equitable city government, the very thing that will also make our city attractive to new residents and new investment. This is the work that we have to remain committed to for the long haul. And as your mayor, you have my commitment. We must show progress over time and provide a way for residents to regularly follow along with our work, not just report on what we accomplished when we are done. Thus, as we reflect on the past year and look ahead, I am very excited to share my action plan with you. This is the culmination of months of diligent collective work, building on the efforts of my transition team and working in partnership with city agency leadership. I am very proud of the roadmap that we have created for what we will achieve together through the rest of this term and beyond. Similar to the 100-day tracker we released in February, this tool allows you to see the goals my administration is committing to making significant progress on and accomplishing over this term. Organized by our five core pillars: building public safety, prioritizing our youth, clean and healthy communities, equitable neighborhood development, and responsible stewardship of city resources. You can follow along with the status of our actions as well as key performance indicators for each goal. I strongly believe that to make progress, we must set ambitious goals and work every day to achieve them. At the start of my term in December of 2020, I embarked on a process to operationalize my vision for the city of Baltimore and give residents a way to see transformation in their city government. My action plan builds on the thorough work of my transition team. More than 250 committed Baltimoreans, including young people, community advocates, business leaders, current and former government officials, artists, and academics who generated clear recommendations for change and progress in Baltimore. That transition report was taken up by my executive team and agency leaders who considered how to bring those recommendations as well as other improvements to life. This action plan seeks to establish measurable goals and intentionally reverse course from outdated policies and strategies that have not yielded results for Baltimore. As a part of my commitment to transparency and accountability, the plan will be updated quarterly, allowing the public to hold us accountable to progress on the ambitious goals we are setting out to accomplish. You can see the action plan at mayor.baltimorecity.gov/tracker. I invite you to follow along with our progress and hold my administration accountable as we prove that a new way forward is possible for Baltimore. I look forward to working with you to build on the foundations that we've set over the past year and transform Baltimore into the stronger, better, safer place to live that we all know it can be. Thank you.